Hi guys, it's Shani from Yiannimize. And hello one and all. That can only mean one thing. I've got Sam from See-Through Glass with me. How you doing, Sam?
Oh, good. How are you?
You well?
Yeah, very well, thank you.
You good?
Good to see you as always.
So, Sam is here, and Sam's driving around the world.
Yeah, well, I'm not quite like manly and mug enough to like drive around the world. I'm driving part of the world, and then flying other parts.
Okay, so you've got a car to do this in?
Yes, 911 Carrera T.
911 Carrera T. Obviously, if you remember, if you click here, you can see when he wrapped his Porsche Cayman. And now he's got a 911 Carrera T.
And upgrading the Porsche game.
And what colour is the car now?
It's now GT Silver. I want the car to be recognisable as it travels around the world. People start to go, oh, it's that car. I've seen it on Instagram. I've seen it on Twitter. And, you know,
okay.
Two and two together.
So what colour have you chose?
So I did go around and back and forth quite a lot, but the inspiration has come from a classic 911. So okay. 1969 911 TR, which the Carrera T was inspired by, which is green. Once again.
So we went green on his Cayman, and now we're going green on his
911. But it's a different green. And I have to give a special plug here to Bert, the man. Yanni gets all the fame on this channel, but Bert's the hidden gem in this place.
Bert? Yeah. Bert, it rings the bell.
Yeah, don't worry. Military green matte. Now, I didn't actually want a matte colour. I know like that's big and popular these days with the kids. But I preferred gloss. So it's got a gloss laminate, is that right?
On top.
On top, which transforms it and makes this colour that I was literally looking for, which we couldn't find anywhere else.
So just bear in mind, that is the matte colour at the moment. We're going to put the laminate on top of it when the roll turns up, and then we're going to apply it to his car. I assume we're doing shuts and returns?
Shuts and returns.
And what else? Is it just a full straight wrap?
Full straight wrap, but I want to try and add some sort of like decals, some like some Porsche logos and stuff. Because again, I want to try and capture as much of the classic car as possible.
Okay.
That is a bit hard. It's got roof rails on it at the moment, the car.
Okay.
So it will have a roof box.
Oh, you're going all out roof box and everything. Where are you going to put your luggage and stuff?
Absolutely, I need to because I can have so much luggage for this trip. But so maybe like on the back, I want to get rid of the Porsche badge and replace it with a sticker, a Porsche sticker.
Okay, what colour?
Well, orange, I think.
Orange.
Again,
I'll
send you the pictures of this car so you can put it on the overlay of this video. Yeah, no, they're not orange, my calipers.
So have you got anything orange on the
car?
No. So we're going to have a Porsche sticker on the back of your car that's in orange.
Yeah, and on the side. So do you remember with the Cayman, we did the Porsche logos on the side? They're okay. In orange as well.
So you're just going to have orange, orange, orange. You're going to have like a stripe or anything?
Yeah, white stripe.
It's green, white, and orange.
It's a classic historic look.
Have you got like yellow calipers?
No, I've got black calipers, I think. Or maybe silver. I don't know what colour calipers are. I literally picked up the car half an hour ago.
Okay, well listen, that's Sam from Seen Through Glass. We're going to wrap his car. I hope you enjoy this video.
On this Porsche, all the shuts are ready to go, they're clean, they're prepped, so we're both going to do one side each, and we'll just see how it goes. It's 10:15 now, so see how long it'll take us.
Wish you luck.
I'm upstairs in the plotter room because the customer's requested to have these kind of stripes put on his new, obviously, Porsche. Being that this is a reference for an old Porsche, we've got to obviously adapt the sizing and everything. So that's what I've been doing at the moment. Keeping with the reference of the old school Porsche, he's also wants these white little stripes to go across the front and back bumper. So again, that's just literally a little rectangle piece that we can cut out, so that won't be too bad to do. He's asked for just a big Porsche decal, so that'll all be included in the cutting at the moment.
So
the shutter. You excited?
I'm so excited, I can't wait.
What are you, and I always ask this on the show, what are you hoping to see?
Well, in my mind, all I keep thinking about is that classic car that I'm sort of, you know, was my inspiration. I know it can't look exactly like that because the shapes are different. But I'm so excited about the colour, it's just whether the other details are correct. That's why I'm a little nervous, but as you can see, I love that car, so I can't wait.
All right, well, I'm going to give him the full treatment. Sam, wait here, and I'm going to bang the shutter.
Okay.
Watch this.
It feels special. When you bang the shutter, it feels special.
I'm loving it. What? It's quite bold, but I like it.
Wow. Have a look, have a little look around. I let him have a little look around. It's not over the top green, is it?
No, it's a lot more subtle than last time. Yeah, it's a more like dirty, desaturated green.
So to make you laugh, I had a customer come in, okay, and they saw it, and they said to me, oh, well, what's this, like an old Porsche? And I'm like, no, it's a new Porsche. And he was like, what do you mean? So exactly what you wanted, you wanted people to think it's an old Porsche. He thought it was an old Porsche. I was like, yeah, no, this is new. And he was like, okay.
It's got the historic look to it. That's the thing which I wanted with the color. It's almost like a pastel color, like, and you don't see that a lot anymore. But, and it's got my plate on it, which I'm so happy
about. Plate's cool, you got a cool plate. Honestly, you happy with the colour?
Yeah, I'm very, very happy with the colour. The thing which I need to decide on are the decals, the stripe and the lettering. Like, that's the thing which I guess is the most controversial part of it.
But it is a wrap, so obviously the stripes can come off and it won't affect the wrap in any way.
Sure.
As long as you do it fairly soon. Don't be sending this to another country and getting the heat on it because it won't come off.
Okay.
So you need to do this before it travels. If you just pan straight over to there, look at Bert.
Hey!
Bert's there. Bert sorted out the colour. Bert done, to be fair, Bert done it all. So I'll give Bert a round of applause for that. Bert, why don't you just come over here? So for people that don't know at home, Bert is my sales operations. He's number two at Yiannimize. If I'm not here, he's in charge. I am here a lot, to be fair. So that don't happen a lot. But Bert pulled it off with this one. He stepped it up. Sam seems very, very happy. He's looking over the car. He's not 100% sure on the white decals with the orange Porsche, but I think he likes the colour. So another job well done.
Slight change of plans. As awesome as the car looked as it rolled out, there was something that wasn't sitting quite right in my mind. I was looking at it and something was jarring a bit, and I think it might be the side sort of decals or stickers. I'm really happy with the orange. I still think the white is the best colour. But I think maybe the extended stripe down the front and the back was maybe what was throwing me off, because we were trying to replicate that historic classic car, and I think maybe it's too hard to do on a modern 911. So yeah, back inside the unit now, making everyone work even more. So we're going to take off the front and rear extension, see how that fits. I think that might help. And then also the sticker on the back, which was the Porsche logo instead of the Porsche badge, was just moving up slightly. Because again, trying to copy the old car, it was just sat a bit wrong, but sorry.
Sam's just bought these and he wants these on the bonnet, so we're going to drill straight through his bonnet.
Oh, nice. Sam.
You forget the feeling of deja vu.
We tried to go beyond, above and beyond for our customers. Sam's like, we ain't got a workshop full of cars. We're not busy at all.
Well, I'm also leaving, the car's leaving for Australia in 2 days. No, less.
And that's my problem. How? Why?
It's not your problem, it's my problem.
Sorry, mate, you're going on like a world tour, but let's stop all work at Yiannimize and, can't wait to give him his bill. So the car is now complete. We've done the reveal earlier and we've done all the hero shots and all the end shots. So when you look at them now, you'll see they're slightly changed. When Sam turned up, there was a couple of things he wanted changed. So he wanted the lights added to the front. He wasn't 100% sure on the stripe down the side, so we lost it off the front bumper and the rear bumper. And the Porsche on the back, we've made it go up slightly.
Absolutely.
And then you saw him fitting these on.
Like a bit of manual labour, mate.
That's it. Besides from that, do you like the car?
Man, I'm so happy now. Thank you so much. Your team have absolutely smashed it, especially with my last minute changes. So yeah, thank you to all your guys girls.
So Sam is now happy and he's going to head off and do a year tour driving around, which is amazing.
I'm so late for the boat. I gotta go.
Listen, I wish you well. Drive safely.
Thank
you so much. Have a fantastic time. And make sure you guys stay tuned to his channel to keep an eye on what he gets up to. It's gonna be crazy. Sam, drive safely, pal. Be good. Thanks for watching. I'll see you soon.